हेलो दोस्तों, मैं हूं डॉक्टर अंजार अहमद एंड यू आर वाचिंग माय चैनल डॉक्टर अंजार अहमद। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट जीएसएम आर्किटेक्चर। जीएसएम आर्किटेक्चर इज डिवाइडेड इनटू फोर सेगमेंट्स। फर्स्ट सेगमेंट इज नोन एज मोबाइल सेट। Second segment is known as base station subsystem, and third is known as network switching subsystem. Fourth, operation and maintenance subsystem. In previous lecture, we have explained about mobile set and base station subsystem segments. Today, I'm going to explain network switching subsystem. Friends, network switching subsystem segments carries out switching and mobility management function for mobile phones. It also manages the communication between MS to MS and MS to PSTN. It is owned and deployed by a mobile phone operator. Let us try to know various functions of network switching subsystem. NSS is called nerve center of entire GSM network. It manages all call processing relating functions and consists following components. The core switching component, MSC, stands for mobile switching center. A number of database register, HLR, VLR, AUC and EIR. Gateways to other network, which is known as gateway MSC. And signaling system 7 to connect other network, for example, public switch telephone network or private data network. Now let me explain each component of NSS in detail. Mobile switching center is known as backbone of NSS, and also it is known as the heart of the GSM network. It manages communication between cellular system and other network, for example PSTN and PADN, with the help of gateway MSC. It performs basic switching functions, setup and monitor end-to-end call connection, call routing, authentication and verification, billing and accounting functions. It connects and terminates several mobile stations via BSC. It also connects other MSC and GMSC. MSC also maintains supplementary services, for example, call barring, call charging, multi-party call support, etc. Other functions of mobile switching centers is related to mobility management of the user. It gets registered to the user and also updates the location of subscriber. MSC also help out in inter BSS and in inter MSC handoff process. All these functions MSC take the help of other database registers, which are known as home location register HLR, VLR, EIR, AUC. Let us try to know what is home location register. HLR stand for home location register, store the administrative information of each subscriber registered in the network. It keeps a permanent database and location of the subscriber data. HLR also holds most of the information held by the SIM, such as MSISTN, mobile subscriber ISDN number, IMS ISI International Mobile Subscriber Identity Number, TMSI stand for Temporary Mobile Subscriber Identity Number, MSRN stand for Mobile Subscriber Roaming Numbers. HLR also consists or tells about the services or subscription of user like prepaid, postpaid, roaming restrictions, supplementary services, etc. HLR verifies a subscriber in the network on behalf of MSC. It updates location of subscriber. Also, it tells about the MSC and VLR location of any subscriber. Visitor location register. VLR holds temporary database of a subscriber. Actually, whenever any subscriber roam to another city or country, then HLR with the help of MSC borrows the database of that subscriber from home location register. VLR keeps and controls those mobiles which roam in its area. Database contains, again same as in HLR, IMSI, TIMSI, MSISDN, MSRN number, location area, authentication key. Authentication center. The function of authentication center is to authenticate each SIM that attempt to connect the GSM core network. It is used by the HLR to authenticate the user. Once the authentication is successful, the HLR is allowed to manage the SIM and services. AUC protects any type of fraud on air interface. It maintains authentication keys and algorithm and provides security triplets to the subscriber in the form of random number, sign response keys and ciphering keys. AUC generally associated with the HLR. Equipment's Identity Register, EIR, contains database that is used to track handset using the IMEI, stand for International Mobile Equipment's Identity Number. IMEI mentioned at the time of manufacturing the device or the handset by the manufacturer itself. EIR maintains three lists of database: whitelist, which belongs to the valid or assigned IDs or subscriber; blacklist, those mobile set which has been reported stolen or blocked due to some reason; and the third is graylist, service allowed but noted. Now, the last segments of GSM architecture, which is known as operation and maintenance subsystem. O and MS is used to configure, control and to monitor the entire GSM network. It comprises two sections, one look after for the switching section and other look after for the radio section. Various functions of operation and maintenance centers. Commonly, the function of ONMCs are provide traffic, provide data traffic data measurement reporting and analysis, store all the data and software for the network elements, perform as the central maintenance control point for all the network elements, maintain all telecom hardware and network operation, maintain all charging and billing procedure related to the subscriber. OMS-S is used in conjunction with the NSS and is used for monitoring switching related issues. On the other hand, OMCR is used in conjunction with the BSS. It controls the traffic load on the various cells and also performs automatic reconfiguration of the transceivers to cope up with the fluctuation of traffic load caused due to the mobility of the customer. How we can find out or diagnose the problem of GSM architecture? Various problem can be seen and monitored by the OMCs, and time to time it can be informed to the concerned person. There are few alarm symbols which shows or indicate some situation of architecture. This is symbol which shows that the situation or that is the situation is critical and immediate action has to be taken. This symbol shows major problem and action can be taken as soon as possible. This shows minor problem, action can be taken when there is a time. And this symbol shows warning, point out condition, and corrective action is then taken during scheduled maintenance time. And this is the symbol which shows the undefined situation. Generated for there is no alarm security in the system. So it was all about the GSM architecture. If you liked it, please subscribe by my channel Dr. Anzar Ahmad, and if you are not liking, then let me know. I will try to improve it. Thank you very much.